Well, not much to talk about on that game, huh?
Oh, my goodness, do we have a lot to talk about on Oklahoma City tying the series with San Antonio. Crazy finish. Series 1-1. You'll hear from...
You know what's sad, Artie? What? The team I picked to win the series, I'm not feeling good about it right now.
And you, obviously we'll hear from the players after that game. A thriller, 98-97. And we'll have the highlights of Game 1 of the Eastern Conference semifinal between Cleveland and Atlanta on Inside, coming up next.
Comment on the last play, the last series there, the sequence.
What exactly would you like me to comment on?
Did you think there should have been a whistle?
Something certainly happened on the sideline, I thought.
Barry Trammell with the Oklahoma. Greg, they came out, Thunder came out clearly different than they did the other day, sort of what you talked about. What was the difference in the way they played, especially early?
Well, I thought it was more of the way we played. I mean, they were in attack mode, which one would expect, but I thought that our organization offensively was really poor, and it fueled their transition offense. That was the main problem.
LA finished with 41 points tonight. What did you think of his effort?
I think I'd have to say it was good.
They went with Roberson tonight on Kawhi most of the game. How did that affect what Leonard did and what you guys were trying to do, either positively or negatively?
Yeah, that's nothing of significance. Our disorganization offensively, I thought, was the most important part of what we did. It ended up in a lot of poor shots. And the best part of it is I thought we lost the game three times tonight and got back in it. So give our guys credit for hanging in there on a night when they weren't very sharp. But individually, we have to play smarter. And I don't think we played very smart tonight in a lot of situations.
Pop, did the play where LaMarcus ends up getting the three free throws, was that designed as one of the options?
Yeah, he was one of the options. We didn't know that he'd get fouled and shoot three free throws, but that's where he was supposed to be.
And with that, we welcome you to Inside the NBA, and here's the play they're talking about.
Deion
Waiters making contact with Manu Ginobili as he attempts to inbound. Nothing called. San Antonio would corral the loose ball and have a chance down the stretch in the last few seconds, but unable to score. And the Oklahoma City Thunder take game two.
How did you miss that call, though?
98-97.
Hey,
I don't know.
Welcome here.
Hey, back up. I can't see Ernie.
Who are you, Deion Waiters? Deion Waiters?
Charles is here. Ernie's here. Shaq is here. Yeah, what?
I've been in NBA for 30 years. I've never seen that.
Me either, ever.
And we sitting here arguing, America. We've been sitting here arguing for the last 20 minutes. Like, what is the official call?
We're trying to get Joe Borgia on, who's the supervisor, the VP of
it's a call, though.
Referees. Yeah,
it's
we want to find out exactly what it is.
So, America, we're sitting here. Chris Webber says an offensive foul.
I say it's a violation.
I say it's a violation also because it'd be like touching.
And a tech. I think it's a tech.
You think so?
I think it's a tech as
Look,
well.
Yeah, it's a tech.
I think that's a tech.
Yeah.
Because I think he's just going to call a violation because the ball, you touch somebody out of bounds.
But he's looking directly at him. I don't understand. How can you not make a call?
This is just, I can't wait for Joe Borgia to give me the official call.
Because the reason I knew the referee, obviously he was looking at him, but you know he's looking at him because
he's talking to Mark Davis right there.
Because he's making the count because he has to see if he's getting it in. So he's looking directly at the play and to not call something,
but you know,
blow the whistle.
I think, being that we've never seen him before, we've been in the game a long time, I don't think he's ever seen a play like that either. And he wouldn't know what to call.
Yeah, that's right. First of all, it looked like
that one go.
I think the ref just panicked. Because it's clearly something. I don't think you can stand out of bounds and
push the guy off.
Because you've seen it the other way. You've seen the defender make right. contact with the guy who's out of bounds and trying to inbound.
And that's right. a technical.
Yeah, but
everyone's – listen, this is one of the greatest players to ever play. Another one. We had 10 people in the back that never played basketball go, what's wrong? That's a violation. Like, right. everyone knows that's something. So regardless if he's never seen
I can't
it before,
wait
he
for the
knew
NBA.
To blow the whistle. I can't, it went, I can't 10 wait. People in the back who've never played before screaming something should have happened.
Yeah, I really
has to do it.
I'm excited to see what the official ruling is.
And
is
it, play that is play. It a tech? If it's a tech, they should get the tech and the ball and play that last 10 seconds.
But again, we're efforting getting Joe Borgia from the replay center in Secaucus, too.
Hey, listen.
Yeah, Joe, put your martini down and call us.
Hey, listen. When I played at Riverside Church, we protested a game and won a protest. I would protest that game. There's a protestable game because there is something wrong with that right there.
Well, let's look at the game in its entirety, the highlights of Game 2.
Man.
In San Antonio, with LaMarcus Aldridge coming off that 38-point game, and he bettered that.
Ernie, are you going to apologize?
Ernie, how many points, how much money did they give LaMarcus Aldridge?
Not enough.
He underpaid. They gave him $90 million. This guy's unbelievable.
Can I get an apology?
No, you can't.
You said you would apologize.
No, this guy's been playing great. No, he's killing them.
But you said you'd apologize.
Here we go. Let's go through this game. We see the first quarter that had OKC. Up 29-21, and then San Antonio comes back at him. Danny Green with that three, and then LaMarcus Aldridge.
He got the righty and the lefty, everything working.
11-2 run.
You got too much stuff, Chuck.
Russell Westbrook, little pocket pass.
Stephen Adams.
Chuck.
Hey, I love that kid right there. This is beautiful.
Yeah, that's a great pass.
Tell you what, him and Cantor are balling right now.
San Antonio would grab the lead after trailing by 13 early. Kawhi Leonard baseline jumper.
You know, Spurs started off the game slow, but you know, with the system that they utilized, they would definitely come back.
They just no stopping LaMarcus Aldridge.
He's sending a limo for Ibaka.
Kevin Durant, little floater. 54-51, and at the half, it was 56-53. Thunder. Third quarter, Russell Westbrook. Going to tippy toe over the outside the line and knock down a three.
Chuck don't like that shot, but hey, Russell was feeling it. Yeah,
and he'll pull up and bury another one. 75-64. But the Spurs are so good at closing out quarters, and they go 8-0 to close out.
Look, what's that to the left?
Oh, that's Julius right there.
Oh, man, this guy.
Guess who? LaMarcus Aldridge.
Too many moves, man. Too many moves.
OKC, 77-76, going to the fourth. Remember, they lost 15 games this year when taking a lead to the fourth quarter. Most in the NBA. But they did not lose the lead in the fourth quarter in this one, though San Antonio
certainly wasn't for lack of effort.
Oh,
that's a charge.
I'm going to tell you what.
No, that's bully ball. Get him up out of there, Kawhi.
That's a charge.
Get him up out of there, Kawhi.
12-2 run. For San Antonio.
Playoffs, Chuck.
Can't just run over people, man.
Or run by them.
Well, how about that?
Run by them is better.
Westbrook just way downhill on that. 91-89.
One more.
Nice pass.
Trust right there. Deion Waiters' first bucket of the game.
Kill Marv Albasset. I'm not used to the Oklahoma City pass the ball four times. That was beautiful.
94-91.
He got fouled.
Durant floats.
Tough in that situation right there.
This pass was incredible.
Oh.
And here's LaMarcus Aldridge, 0-16 in the regular season from out there, 1-1 in the postseason, and now 2-2.
And this is just
got him.
Oh, and then Ibaka fouls him out
that's
there.
That's the what? WTH.
Got him.
Come on, man.
And LaMarcus, he's done everything else. Why not just go to the line and knock down three free throws, which he did. One-point game.
Come on, there it is.
God.
Come on, man.
And
they still got the steal, too.
And give Stephen Adams credit for getting back on that point.
This shot right here, Kenny by Patty?
That's his shot.
Yeah.
That's his shot, though.
But that one might have been a foul, too.
You know.
Huge scramble, and the clock runs out on the San Antonio Spurs as Oklahoma City.
Look at this.
Rebounds from a 2-point loss in game one. To win by one.
I don't think he gets to take the ball out anymore.
Man, it was just like.
Yeah, that is crazy. That's crazy he was taking the ball out.
Come on, man. But listen, man. That might be the worst non-call in a playoff game I've seen in the last 5 years.
98-97, Billy Donovan's Thunder tie the series, and here is the OKC head coach.
I really felt like our guys would respond, and they play hard, and they compete. And, you know, I thought we got a really good effort by everybody. I think everybody contributed in different ways. I thought Aldridge obviously had a great game. But again, I thought we made it really, really hard on him. He made some very difficult shots and got some points late from the three-point line. But, you know, overall, I felt like we did some really good things coming down the stretch execution-wise. I really thought that Russell and Kevin trusted the pass and generated some open shots for some other guys, which I thought was really helpful. And then, obviously, you know, we were fortunate to close out the game the way we did. We had a chance, but, you know, fouling a three-point shooter there. And then being out of a timeout and having a hard time inbounding the ball, we got fortunate, you know, and it's obviously a hard place to win. And there's a reason they have the record they do here at home. So I think any way you can find a way to come in and compete the way we did, we were fortunate to win. But, you know, it's only one game.
Dean Blevins, News 9. Can you try to explain what happened there at the end and if there was a bad call or if the officials said anything to you?
On which
well,
one?
Well, on the inbound and the no call.
On Kevin, you mean?
Well, on Waiters. If just did you get any explanation?
I'm not sure what you're talking about.
Well, the play of the game at the end of the game when Waiters passed it inbounds. Did you have any clarification from the officials if they made any if anything about the call?
I'm not sure what call you're talking about. We inbounded the ball and they stole it.
Yeah, there was a question about whether Waiters.
Oh, I didn't hear anything about that at all. I apologize. I didn't hear anything about that at all. So I'm not. I haven't seen the clip. Obviously, I thought, you know, the ball got thrown up. Kevin lost his footing and fell down. You know, I don't know if he got fouled on the play or not. Obviously, it was a scramble there at the end, and we were able to come up with a loose ball. But I don't know. I don't know that part of it. I apologize because I wasn't really quite sure what you're talking about.
Barry Trammell with the Oklahoma.
And probably from his angle, if he's over there on the Oklahoma City bench.
He knew what the heck he
First
was doing.
First of all, Ernie, he knows.
He knew what he's talking
he's
about.
Seen
That's
the play.
Diversity.
He's seen the play already.
From New York, Ernie. Yeah. One slick with it.
Come on. Look at the difference between game one and game two. The San Antonio offense in this series are held to 97 after scoring 124, 43% after 61%, and after a 39 assist night in game one, they don't get 20. In game two, and credit Oklahoma City, they bounce back from a blowout in game one to tie the series at a game apiece. How do you put this one into perspective, Shaq, when you look at it big picture?
Well, we knew OKC was going to come out with a lot of energy. You know, they were thinking about it yesterday, thinking about it today and shoot around. We got to come out with more energy, play a little bit harder. They did that. You know, the Spurs and the system, they never panicked. They will always fight back. They will always be in the game. You know, besides a few bonehead plays, I think they played very well. You know, they did play hard. You know, they won the game. Last call was questionable, but we can't, you know, talk about it now. The series is 1-1. They went and took home court advantage away from San Antonio. Now they have to protect their home court advantage, go win too. But best believe San Antonio will not shoot 43% in game three. Guarantee you on that.
You know, Aaron, I got to, you know, even though they won the game, man, they make so many mental mistakes. I mean, that last play, they got away with the offensive violation of offensive foul. They just threw a ball up for grabs to Kevin Durant. They fouled a three-point shooter again. But I won't give Kenneth some credit because he said before the series that LaMarcus Aldridge was going to kill these guys. I don't think he thought he was going to average 40.
No, I didn't think he was.
But, yeah, man, they got to do something to slow him down. I mean, he had basically 40 in game one. He had 35. And then you think, like, well, they're going to play great defense on him in game two. He come back and light him up for 41. And you can't expect Kawhi Leonard to go 7 for 18. To me, the one guy on the Spurs who's got to pick it up is Tony Parker. He only had 7 tonight. You know Kawhi's going to get a certain moment in the markers, but Tony Parker got to pick it up, man. Because he's a great player, obviously.
David West, too, Chip.
David West, he's coming out the middle. I'm talking about, you know, but Tony Parker is a Hall of Famer. He's got to get more than 7 points. And the stats say, which I don't even like that stat, because he's minus 14, which is stupid. But Tony Parker's the one guy, because you can't let Russell Westbrook play just on one end. You got to kind of counterbalance him.
33 for 44 from the field is LaMarcus Aldridge in this series. Yet, look, OKC ties the series. They get 28 from Durant. They get 29, 7, and 10 from Westbrook tonight.
Well, honestly, your expectation is for those two guys to do what they do on the offensive end. And just to go back to what Charles is saying, but the expectation is also that they will do the same things that they did down the stretch in close games. So if you had to favor in a seven-game series, you would just say San Antonio eventually will win more of those type of games than they will lose type of games. So that's the question mark. The question mark has nothing to do with Westbrook able to get 30, Durant able to get 30. It's can you not make four mistakes down the stretch or four plays that will destruct your offense and your ability to possibly win a game? And that, can you win a championship doing that? Because the reason that everyone's saying it, including us, is that it happens in the regular season. The same thing happens. It doesn't, it's not different. So it's not like we're coming up with something and picking on the Oklahoma City Thunder. We're like, well, hey, remember that game against Golden State? Steph Curry hit that three and how he got to hit. Like, you can go back to games and say you let people do things like this all the time. So
long way.
Can you win an NBA championship doing that? I don't know. I've never seen that.
Ibaka 12, Adams 12, Cantor 12, and also 17 rebounds for Steven Adams in this one. Oklahoma City. They outshoot San Antonio 48-43%. They did turn it over 18 times for 24 points, but they hold on and tie the series. And now game three is Friday.
They don't play again until Friday?
On ESPN. And we are all tied up at a game apiece. The Thunder taking home court away from San Antonio. That's the replay center. We are waiting.
Put the martinis down and get on the phone.
Hopefully
we can talk to you.
With Joe Borgia.
I just saw your head, Joe. He was putting that martini down.
You're watching Inside. Got a long way to go. Keep it here.
Dennis Schroeder in the middle. Now he gets the pick from Al Horford. Dennis goes alley-oop for Al. He catches and jams! And the Hawks have taken the lead! 80-79! First lead of the night.
Inside the NBA, presented by Kia, is brought to you by Kia, official automotive partner of the NBA.
The NBA app is the best way to stay up to date on scores, stats, and breaking news. Download it now and get an all-access look into all things playoffs. The Cleveland Cavaliers, remember them? Haven't seen them in 8 days since a first-round sweep of the Pistons. It was another 4 days before they knew who they'd play in the Eastern Conference semis, and it turned out to be the team they've never lost a game to in the playoffs, the Atlanta Hawks. LeBron and the Cavs swept them in this round in 09, and then in the conference finals last year when the Hawks had the home court. The Cavs have it this time around, so we head to the queue for game one. Jeff Teague in Atlanta, LeBron James, and the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Started out real strong, Ernie. A lot of energy.
Give me that.
Getting on the break.
This ball's going back and forth. And eventually we'll wind up in the hands of LeBron James.
Oh, good. Get out my way. I'm Deion Waiters.
Cavs hit 6 out of 11 from deep in the first quarter. That's all JR makes, isn't it?
Shannon
Fry. That's what they bought him here for, Ernie.
30-19 after one, Cavs. Meantime, Al Horford and Paul Millsap were struggling. In fact, Horford, no points in the first half.
Hate to be redundant, but if the Hawks want any success, those two have to step up.
They were 2-for-16 combined in the first half. Watch LeBron on the play coming up. In fact, a couple of plays coming up. The fastball he throws over here to Richard Jefferson.
How you know that wasn't a slider?
It looked like a fastball from the rotation. And then the bounce pass to Jefferson.
Got him. Now that was sweet.
He sees the floor, man.
51-41.
That's a hard pass.
Okay, Richard. Oh, man, Jefferson.
At the half. Kevin Love just 1 for 10 in the first half. Finished the night 4 for 17. Bank that in, and then
where you keep your money at, Ernie?
4-3.
Bang, bang bang. Chuck hates that shot, but Big Chuck.
No, I don't mind. I don't hate that shot. I just don't want
to. Can't be his only diet.
Just diversify.
Yeah, diversify, Ernie. Like you know, that's what Kenny would do with my bank account if he was my financial advisor.
I would diversify.
Heaven forbid. 72-54, 18-point lead for the Cavs. But then the Hawks go 16-2 to end the quarter.
Dennis Schroeder played great tonight.
Nuts, man.
Yeah, Goldie shooting the ball, extra arch on it. Looking
played well until the last 2 minutes of the game.
He had 27, which is a career high.
Well.
Playoffs or otherwise. Yeah, Bazemore did too. So, 74-70 going to the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you got to dunk this ball. Got to dunk that, Kev.
Give me that.
Yeah. Millsap with the huge block, and then it's Schroeder again. He was all over the floor, and here he's got Al Horford up top. And the Hawks have the lead for the first time, 80-79.
Then Kyrie Irving took over.
He knocked that. When I was going back and forth here, they're kind of riding the seesaw because Schroeder is going to drive.
Okay, Goldie, I see you, Goldie.
Oh, that's the way, that's like summer league. Goldie. You score, I score.
Atlanta was up 88-87, and JR did the tough shot thing again.
Tough shot.
Like Vernon Maxwell on that shot.
Man.
Oh, and then Kevin Love.
Big play.
Bazemore right on the right shoulder.
Now, he had the shoulder. That's the same shoulder?
No, he had the left shoulder last year, the right shoulder this time.
You got to quit doing it. You got to be careful, man.
He hit 2 out of 3 free throws for a 92-88 lead.
LeBron, then, too strong.
Yep, part of a 10-0 run for LeBron there. And then, now it's the left ankle. You got the right shoulder. You got the left ankle.
Miles Spring, he'll be all right.
He'll be all right.
Thank you, Dr. O'Neill.
After he plays these next 3 more games, he'll get to rest some time.
104-93, the final 17-5 finish for the Cavs to finish off the Hawks in game one, and they are now 9-0 all time in the postseason against Atlanta. LeBron 25-7-9, and he spoke to Lewis Johnson after the game. Mm.
Well, LeBron, just how tough was it to get this game one from Atlanta?
First of all, you give a lot of credit to the Atlanta Hawks. They brought it today. Obviously, you can tell that they went through a longer series than us. 8 days is a long time, and we try to do whatever we could to stay in rhythm, to stay in shape. But we just pushed through it. You know, a win is a win in the postseason. We're going to get better, obviously, as the series go on, but it's a great start to the series.
I thought the way our guys competed, really, for the whole night, was what we need, you know, tonight going forward. And I think we can play better. Obviously, Dennis had a great game for us. But defensively, you know, I think we had some possessions where we gave ourselves a chance, and we just couldn't quite come up with a couple of big rebounds late.
They just got stops at the end, and I think we got stops too, but they got the offensive rebound, and I think down the stretch it can't happen like that.
Tristan, you know, when teams play great defense for 24 seconds and he comes up with those rebounds, it's just demoralizing to the team because now they got to come out and guard us again.
You know, we have, you know, so many opportunities there the last 4 minutes. You know, myself, I had to be a lot better. You know, I missed some easy bunnies, and you got to give them credit. You know, they shot the crap out of the ball, but, you know, we'll be back in game two and we're going to have another go at it.
We felt like we knocked some of that rust off tonight. Second half was tough on the defensive end, but we know that we can play better. Good thing is we'll go in tomorrow, look at some film, and know that, you know, we could have given one away tonight, especially on our home floor.
Coors Light, cold, hard facts. Paul Millsap, 6 for 19. You see Horford, 4 for 13. Teague, 2 for 9. Kyle Korver got one shot off in this game.
And they still had opportunity to win.
How did this happen? Take me through what, especially J.R. Smith, was doing defensively with Kyle Korver.
Well, you just stay home. You know, you be alert. You stay home. You chase him off the screen. Make him put the ball on the floor. That is the one thing that you have to do with Kyle Korver. You continue to find him. See, he will not allow him to take a pull-up jump shot. He says, if you're going to take a shot, you're going to take it off the dribble. And Kyle Korver refuses to take the ball off the dribble and shoot the basketball.
If you ask him to look at these plays, you know how they always say on defense, you have your eyes on the ball? He's looking at Kyle Korver the entire time.
You ain't letting him score.
Nope.
that's actually JR paying close attention to the game plan.
Yeah.
I mean, he's not, you know, normally you not that I was a great defender, you know, you're supposed to be open trying to help. You can see in those highlights, he's got his eyes
out.
No help. And if you don't lead Kyle Korver, he has a tough time getting a shot off.
And he's got to, you know, I don't know if it's too late in his career, but he's got to learn to, you know, like J.J. Redick, who was a great shooter and when he first came in and he had trouble. And then now he is able to put the basketball on the floor, two dribbles, he gets to the rim. So now it allows him to get that space. And Kyle Korver has to figure out this series and say, I'm going to dribble to try to score. Otherwise, he will not score this series.
And, you know, Kyle Korver, like, if you take him out of his game early, he has nothing else to go to. You know, he's one of the top shooters in the league, and to add on to what you said, but makes him different from a guy like Steph Curry. Steph Curry can put it between his legs, drive to the hole, and finish at the basket. Kyle Korver, if you stop him from shooting, I don't want to use the word quit, but he'll just stop playing.
One field goal attempt for Korver on the night, which he missed. When we come back, we're still waiting to see if we can talk to Joe Borgia.
Joe.
About this play. We will hear from Manu Ginobili about this play.
Well, if Joe Borgia flagrant one in the next 2 minutes, let's forget about it, because it's not that big of a deal. Y'all just want to keep us here all night.
Shucks. Come on.
It's here. The first ever championship for the NCAA's fastest growing sport.
Come on, we came to blow up the scene. We had la pala pala rules, we're making history.
These talented athletes will have their moment in the sun. 3 days of action, countless memories, and a new champion crown, live from Gulf Shores, Alabama. NCAA Women's Beach Volleyball Championship, May 6th through 8th on True TV and TBS.
So that's coming up there.
Oh, hey, Chuck.
And there's your sideline reporter, Charles Barkley.
See, y'all some funny people.
If you wear that outfit, we'll let you work the sideline.
Yes.
You can wear Speedos. If you wear the Speedos, you can work the sideline.
I mean, I've been working out hard. I've been doing my hot yoga every day, been doing spinning. And y'all think my body look like that?
Yes.
Yes. Exactly like that. Ain't that right, Rob?
I like how you got your feet dug into the sand.
Ain't that right, Rob?
You should see how before you start spinning in hot yoga.
Funny guys. Y'all some funny guys around here. Oh, it's okay, America.
All right, if you're just joining us, Oklahoma City has tied the series with San Antonio. 1-point win at AT&T Center. Controversial finish to this game. Manu Ginobili involved, and Craig Sager had a chance to talk to him after the game.
It's a game, but one play at the end, one non-call. From your perspective, what happened on the inbounds play?
Didn't you see it?
We saw it and we replayed it. It looked like you were guarding Waiters closely.
I was trying to pressure the ball and he kind of created room with his elbow, but, you know, things that it's a very awkward play. It doesn't happen very often, so I guess, you know, didn't see it. And with all that, I mean, we complain about that because that's what we do. But we had the ball, we had a great shot, we had a few other opportunities, so it's, you know, things that happen.
You don't think the game was stolen from you by a bad call?
No, not at all.
What happened on that last one? To clarify, do you think that was an offensive foul?
I don't know what it is. What type of violation it is? Gotta be something. But again, it's not that play that decided anything, because we got the steal, we got a shot, we got an offensive rebound. So, you know, I really don't know. I never seen anything a play like that. So I don't know what should have been called. Or if it should have been called anything. I mean, they're gonna say. And it doesn't matter. It's over. I'm not going to be able to change it. Nobody's going to change it. It's 1-1. We got to go to OKC and try to win the game.
That's great, man.
I hear you three guys who have been around forever. I hear Manu Ginobili, who's been around forever.
I've never seen it.
And he's talked to his teammates, and nobody's ever seen it before.
Closest seen was when Matt Barnes faked the ball in Kobe's face. And I was like, I wonder if he would have hit him, what would have happened?
That would have been a technical.
So is that a technical then?
No.
It's the same thing. He threw an elbow. It's the same thing.
I think if you hit a
guy. Unsportsmanlike conduct? He threw an elbow.
I think that's different when you hit a guy in the face with the ball. Yeah, but you know what people are really mad? Let's just say you call a violation, San Antonio's Spurs ball. Popovich has a couple seconds to call a play. Game over San Antonio.
But if it's a technical foul, they would have got
the free throw
and
San
the ball. They would have won. It could have won.
Popovich calling the play. Game over.
I don't know what the call is. We need to find out what the call is.
I just thought
it's too late at night.
I thought my man Ginobili had to agree. Like,
I don't know what it was. Because like I say, I can't think of anything that I've ever seen in my 30 years at NBA was something like that happen.
I got a couple of referees in speed dial. We're going to have to call.
I was going to call a couple of my referee friends, but it's like 1 o'clock in the morning.
We got to wake them up, Chuck, because this is very important. We got to make
referees on speed dial, huh?
I knew it, Chuck.
I knew it. That's why I got all the calls. Wake them up.
While we're going through other stuff, you call the referees.
Or when we come back.
Chuck is on the phone.
That's why you got all the calls, Chuck.
Some entertaining day off dialogue from Andrew Bogut.
Oh, you got him on speed dial. You always had him on
speed dial. Golden State's game 2 with Portland.
The quest for the Dunk King begins after Game 1 of the Western Conference Finals on TNT.
I promise you, I will be dunking.
For the second straight season, two-time NBA champion LeBron James and defending champion Draymond Green are taking fans behind the scenes of their playoff journeys with unprecedented access and exclusive footage from the players' perspectives in a new uninterrupted original series titled Trophies, available at facebook.com/uninterrupted. You want some Draymond Green? Here you go.
He's the guy with the trophies, right?
You know, so this, this series is a pretty tough matchup. You know, we were able to get it done today. And, you know, I think, you know, if we can prepare through this series and, you know, get it done, you know, I think this will help us out in the long run. I think, you know, they're a very good team with, you know, guys who can score the ball. But, you know, it teaches us to be disciplined as well. You know, they had 9 turnovers today. So they're, you know, disciplined and not going to lose that, you know. And, you know, that'll help us out. You know, as far as Steph goes, you know, preparing without Steph, we got to prepare to play this entire series without him, you know. And if he comes back, great. But if not, you know, we got to continue to hold it down. And we do that, you know, by a complete team effort. You know, moving the basketball, everybody cutting and getting, most importantly, getting it done on the defensive end. You know, so we got to keep that up. And as far as, you know, my performance today, you know, it was great. You know, I think I could have did a lot of things better. But overall, you know, I think I played a pretty good game and got to continue to build on that for the rest of the series.
Tuesday, Heat and Raptors open up their series in Toronto after both winning in Game 7s on Sunday. Blazers and Warriors play Game 2 out there at Roracle. And today in a media session, Andrew Bogut was holding court.
Are you annoying?
Am I annoying?
On the court.
It depends who you ask.
I'm asking you.
Possibly, yeah.
Do you mind?
If you want to use that word.
You are an asshole?
Yeah, 100%.
Can we put that in?
Why not?
And what makes you an asshole?
Well, there's a bunch of factors. I mean, I'm a foreigner, so that's number one. It gets you voted in the top 5 dirtiest. I just tell it like it is, so, you know, whatever. I don't really care what people label me as, and a lot of people label me as that, so, you know, people that know me, no, I'm very sarcastic and have a sense of humor. The people that don't think I'm an asshole, so.
I think you're a good asshole.
So do I.
Pretty deep X's and O's there.
Yeah. Chuck did his homework, y'all.
Yeah. Let's talk about this conversation that we had. We're not going to name who you talked to, obviously.
It's a violation for sure, or it could be unnecessary contact.
Which is a technical.
But it's definitely a violation. It's a violation, or if you felt like the
unsportsmanlike contact.
Or unsportsmanlike contact. So
or an balls over the line, too.
Or an offensive foul.
Yeah. Yes. But it's something.
What about the ball being over the line?
Yes. Or taking the ball over the line is also a violation. That's the violation part. So those were all the things that our secret ref gave.
Hey, you know who has also never seen
He's
it.
Never seen it either.
Yeah.
He never seen it either, which is incredible.
You know, listen, the ref just they blew that call. They didn't try to blow it. I actually think if some you never see, you're not sure what the call. But listen, man, they just missed that call. But that wasn't. I love the way Ginobili handled it. That did not. He said, "Hey, man, that didn't cost us the game."
Yes, it did. I'm sorry. No.
Well, Andy said it's already happened. There's nothing we can do.
We can
change it. We're going to go.
But, you know, in fairness, they did get the ball.
But in fairness, if you give me a technical and the ball, I can win the game.
He said it could have been just
a... Popovich has a chance to call
but,
a
play. No, he had only down one.
But I'm saying...
So you get a technical.
But it could have been a violation.
You score, you know, and you have the ball.
But I'm saying it could have been a violation.
I would take my chances with that. Kawhi Leonard having the ball in his hands with seven seconds.
I love the way Patty Mills with the ball. I love the way the Spurs handle it. They said, no, that one play.
They better than me because I would have been mad.
Well, that's a lot of people better than me.
And much thanks to the mystery official for shedding some light on a very murky situation in San Antonio.
I like that word.
Charles Fuller referees. I knew it.
He's got them all.
Oh, I know.
Inside the NBA. Presented by Kia, is brought to you by Kia, official automotive partner of the NBA.
It's time for
EJ's Mino Saddler Night.
Presented by No
One. I'm a sponsor.
Unsullied by sponsorship. Bleacher Report tweeter LeBron James will reportedly star in Space Jam 2.
The Hollywood Reporter
had that story, and now, nobody's really confirming it, but it looks like it is in the works and all that. So,
well, who's going to play me?
Excellent point.
Jared Sullinger.
Because in the original, in 1996, of course, Chuckster, hey. We have a clip, Chuck.
Oh, my God. Do we really?
Yes, we do.
I promise I'll never swear again. I'll never get another technical. I'll never trash talk.
Yeah.
And it's this girl. 5 feet nothing. Block my shot.
When did you first start having this dream?
It wasn't a dream. It really happened.
Head shaking reaction from Shaquille O'Neal.
And I thought Kazam was bad. Oh, that was terrible. Oh, wow. Whoa. That's worse than Kazam.
He lost the glasses and everything. Oh, hell no.
Hey, first of all, I got nominated for an Academy Award.
No, I don't think so.
No, you didn't.
Come on, exactly. Good.
Hey, Chuck, I got a feeling. You're Danny Ainge in there. How about that?
Hey, man, I'm not going to lie.
In 1996, I thought that was kind of a good movie. In 2016, that looks
cool. That was awful.
That is awful.
So in that movie...
I can't
movie,
do my shot.
You and several of the players get your talents stolen by these monsters. So we're going to kind of play a who he play for. It's just who he. And so we're going to show you these monsters. You can tell me if you remember. Whose talents did Bang steal?
Sean Bradley?
No.
Patrick, good luck with Sacramento King. Get that job, man.
How about Bupkis?
Larry Johnson?
Hey, correct.
Okay.
One out of two. Pound.
You don't remember this.
Pound. I'm trying to think. Did I say Sean Bradley?
Yeah, you did. You missed it again because that was you.
Dummy.
Wait, y'all made me a...
Oh, yeah, that was
wait,
you.
Y'all made me a fat pound guy?
How about not?
Sean Bradley.
Sean Bradley.
No, that was Muggsy Bogues.
And
Blanco.
Oh, you got to know Blanco.
Come on, this is it. This got to be Sean Bradley.
Oh, very good.
Thank you.
There you go. So you got two out of those five correct. And of course, your history with Sean Bradley. Well chronicled.
Oh, get him, Sean.
He stole your talent again. He stole your talent. Sean Bradley stole your talent. I told you,
nothing good can happen when you play defense, America.
Man, I can't walk. Like you got shot.
I did get shot, man.
Oh, I can't walk.
He hit me, it's a muscle in my back. It's a muscle in there.
That was the same move you made.
Shaq did a fool before I was born.
Come on. Look at the fans. Nobody even pay you attention. When you walked out there, it was like...
Seen his head, Kenny? Yeah, he was like... All the fans were like this.
Hey, man.
Fans are doing you like this.
I couldn't play. My last year in Houston, I couldn't play. I couldn't act either.
Touch me right there, Ernie.
All right, here it is.
Yes. Come on, man.
Diva. I lost my powers. I lost my powers.
That's the same shake you had when Sean Bradley hit you, man.
You guys, you say you have some other Sean Bradley films up there? Oh, we had no idea that he had acting chops. So what else was he in?
Oh,
there he is in Titanic.
Oh,
he's just so tall.
One of my five favorite movies of all time, Braveheart.
Braveheart.
Lord of the Rings. Now, what's this one? Lord of the Rings.
Oh, man, leave Sean Bradley. Sean Bradley's a good dude, man.
Yes, he is. That's
great stuff.
Sean Bradley ain't never hurt nobody.
How long have we been on, Jeremy?
Hey.
As we're fixing to sign off, how long have we been on? Has it been an hour? 45.
Hey, I just want to thank Mike Mathis, my secret official.
Mike Mathis. Well, we were hoping to get Joe Borgia on here for an explanation, but apparently.
Yeah. We got Mike Mathis.
That was not Mike.
My favorite official of all time.
That wasn't Mike Mathis. Stop it.
Ah, look at this. Ooh.
Hello, watch
your Keith Jones. Miss you, Keith Jones.
Yeah. We're back tomorrow with another.
Space Jam was Ben Kazam. Guarantee you, little kids watch Space Jam. Nobody watched Kazam.
There is not a Kazam 2 coming.
Oh, it looks like Shaquille O'Neal in Space Jam 2.
Oh, Lord.